Hi everyone, it's spring! Yay! So, I brought in some tulips today. Or, actually, yesterday I think. To keep me company inside, because it's spring and my bulbs are starting to peak their heads above the ground and getting ready to show what kind of flowers they will bring. And I'm already rambling and it's not even a minute into the video. Anyway! Welcome to my video. My name is Ingeborg, also known as The Stitch Too Far, and this is my Vlogtube channel in which I share my cross stitching progress. Today is Sunday. It is actually close to noon. It is Sunday the 12th of February. It's difficult to say. Anyway, and it's a beautiful sunny weekend over here, and I've been working in my garden already, and yesterday as well, getting it ready for spring. And let's talk stitching, because I've got a lot of things to share, and this might be another long one, I'm afraid. I'll try and keep it brief. I'm checking my notes to see if there's anything I need to talk about. And I do need to talk about the silk thing that I talked about in my previous video. And the NPI silks that I received, which I was doubting if they were silk. Thanks to some of you who actually pointed me towards the burn test, which is a test to see what kind of fabric something is made out of, or thread, or whatever you want to call it. So I did that, and it turns out it is actually silk that I got, so I don't know why it looks and feels different, but at least I know I got what I ordered, so that's a good thing. But yeah, it's still a bit weird. Anyway, enough said about that, I think. There's one other thing I need to show because I forgot last time. This is a ring I usually wear. When I travel, I usually travel far away, and I've been to Indonesia, and usually when I travel far away, I bring back a little piece of jewelry as a souvenir, because that's something that I will actually use, and it will remind me of the trip. So when I went to Indonesia, I was in Yogyakarta, which is on Java, and they are well known for their silversmithy. That's a word, I don't know. Anyway, I bought this ring there, and why I bought it, I got a comment about it saying that they liked it. It's actually, if you can see, there's two moving parts and it's just one ring, but there's two moving rings inside of it. That's why I like it. And I almost always wear this ring. Anyway, I forgot to mention that in the previous video. And I'm sorry about my hair, it's a mess. I still need to take my bath and wash my hair today, so. Oh yeah, one more thing I want to say before I start showing my stitching. Some floss tuber, maybe it was Kay, pointed me towards a new floss tuber, and I would like to give her a shout out as well. I don't usually do it, but her floss tube name is Stitch Bliss Corner. I will try and insert it somewhere on the screen. Her name is Mary Rose, or Mari Rose, and she does floss tube videos. She's quite a prolific video maker. I think she makes one every couple of days, but she makes 15-20 minutes ones, and they're not the usual setup with just showing your whips, but she picks a topic and which is stitching related and shows some of her work in that discussion of that topic, and it's really interesting and I really like it, and I think you should go and check her out. So that's all I need to say. And now let's just show you what I've been up to. And I have practically all my whips sitting beside me, so that means I have plenty to show. I did my normal rotation. Every 3 days I switch out a project. Actually, I do vary on that, and I might as well show you how I do that. I print out a calendar, and I don't know if you can see, but I write down in pencil on each day what I have planned to work on. And I write in pen what I actually worked on. And sometimes I set a goal for a specific project, like to finish, to get to the bottom of a page, or to finish a certain motif in the design or something like that. And sometimes I get to that sooner, or I get to it later, and then I will, because you don't always have the same amount of stitchy time every day. So that's why I don't strictly say 3 days. I just take 3 days as a general guide and set myself a goal and see if I get there or not, and if I want to switch or not after 3 days. It was the start of a new month, so I finished up on the Sunday after I published my last video. I finished working on my goals for Death by Cross Stitch, which I'll show you, because my goal was to reach the actual top left corner and finish the top motif, the long one with the birds. And I have, if you're new to my channel, I'll always put my, all the whips I show you, I put all the information in the description thingy below, with the kind of fabric and the stitch count and whatever. So here's where I got to. I reached my goal. I finished this whole top border bird motif thing. I've actually started to work on the border that's going down along the side. And I went to the actual end of the page, which is over here. So I took all the border down along the top. So the top part is done now. And I am very pleased that this is finally done, because this was quite... this around here, it got quite tedious actually. I got sick of the birds. I need something else. So, but I finished it, and now I can actually move on to something else. So, then it was time for my new start, because it was getting close to the 1st of March. And I mentioned that in my previous video, that it was going to be perennial border. And I might insert a picture, because I forgot to take everything out. I think I actually need to pause, because I need to show you something on that picture. Yeah, back, because I needed to show you. Crinkle, crinkle. I could have done that just now, but I didn't. So this is the pattern by the Drawn Thread, the perennial border it's called. And I told you last time that I was not sure about which fabric to use. And thank you all for those who suggested which one they like best. Actually, I went with the blue. And I started. I made a good start. And when I start a project, I do like it now that I can actually work on it for 3 days. I don't want to start a project and just go 10 stitches and say, okay, it's a start. I really want to enjoy working on it. So I did. And here's where I got to. As you can see, I did all the center bits in the specialty stitches. And trying to see. Yep. That was lots of fun. I really enjoyed that. It was good to get some specialty stitches in again. And I actually did more than what you've seen, because I did start on, if you look at the pattern, I did the center bit, and there's another border going around it. Yeah, I started that 3 times, and I did it wrong 3 times. And I couldn't figure out why. I did miscalculate twice, so that's why in the first times it went wrong. And then in the end, I finally found out that I marked on my working copy where I should start, and that was wrong. That was one stitch off, so I went a stitch too far on this. So, and then I got sick of it, and then I thought I could do this again for the fourth time and do it right, but I will save that for when I'm not feeling this grumbly about it. So this is now my rotation, and we'll come back in a few, probably 2 weeks or something like that. But yeah, absolutely loving it. I like the blue that I selected. It's pretty close to real life, what you're seeing here. Well, not now, because somehow the light changes, but yeah, this is more like it. Yep, then done that, started that, loving that. And then I went back to the beach. And I still haven't decided on how to proceed. I'm thinking about actually just filling in the top part. But I did manage to get another full diagonal in. It took me more than 3 days to do. But hey, I was feeling it and I didn't want to finish. So here's where I'm at with Takapuna Beach. And it's starting to look more and more like trees. You can clearly see that these are like branches now, and there's branches coming down here. Actually, this is about halfway from the top to the bottom. So there's going to be sea coming in here, and then the beach will be somewhere here where it's vacant now. But yeah, I love it. And what I'm thinking about doing is somehow working around this area now, trying to fill in with diagonals like that. So filling in more sky and then going and rolling up and going along more with a diagonal again. But I'm not convinced yet. I'm still having doubts about what's the best thing to do, because I am scared that I might change the tension somehow and there will be a line showing. So maybe I just scroll up and down. I don't know. We'll see. I might try scrolling up and down, and if I don't like it, then I can always think of something else again. And what was really funny, on a nice surprise, was I posted my progress on this on Instagram, and somebody contacted me and said, oh, how nice to see someone stitch this. And I was like, oh, that's really nice, I stitched it too. And she said, no, I designed it. I thought that was really funny. So, Carrie, I think her name is, who has the original hanging on her walls, has found me on Instagram, which I found very funny. Okay, moving on, because I really want to keep this going and maybe even go outside for a bit more. The next thing I worked on was my ink circles, circus of squares, and last time you saw it, I think I had reached the bottom of the third page and I was going to fill in so that I would be halfway across. I reached that goal and I actually had to move my scroll bars, so I'm going to show you like this. Because, as you can see, I'm halfway done, more than halfway done, because this is actually the center. And this, where is the bottom right-hand corner. So what I did is, since last time you saw it, I filled in this motif and this one and some of this, I think. And then I just started doing all the square outlines, because that was easy stitching and I felt like easy stitching. And so this is about by the last page, page 6, and yeah, this is the bottom. So yeah, I will definitely finish this year, and I am so loving how this looks. Yeah, can't wait to finish this. Really excited. I'm getting that feeling, you know what you get. I don't know if everyone gets that, but I get a feeling when I'm past the halfway mark, when you sort of can smell the finish line and you just want to get going on it. I'm not going to, because I think Yeah, there's more than one piece that I have that feeling at the moment, so if I do that, then yeah, that won't be fun. I think I'll get burnt out. But yeah, I'm really having fun. I don't know, I think it's also the fact that it's spring and it's light again, and I really feel more and more every year that in the winter I just go and I just sort of shut down. And as soon as I noticed it's being light outside, I felt my energy levels go up again. So I'm just having, I just feel better all in all, you know, I'm more energetic, and that's always nice. So yeah, I'm so happy that winter will be gone soon. As soon as we have daylight saving switch again, then we'll be fine. So I worked on something else again until yesterday, Saturday, which is my Christmas tree. And Brian, you need to get this. If you don't, I'm gonna send it to you. Okay, so I had to move again because, as you can see, it just doesn't fit quite all the way. But yeah, I was here the last time you saw it. I did the red things, and I needed to finish one. I did finish this one, and then I added all the leaves, and then I just felt like seeing if I could reach the bottom of the tree. So I did all the brown and all the branches, and here's the bottom. So yeah, I finished all the branches and the stem, and now it's just time to get ready to fill in all the leaves and all the berries in the bottom part, and then it will be done. So that's what I meant when I said there's more than one piece that I can smell the finish line. Yeah, I love it. What I am noticing, I think, well, this is linen actually, but there's one piece, oh yeah, the perennial border one, which is not a linen, which is an even weave, Murano, I think. And I am noticing the difference now, and I actually prefer linen. And the difference is that I feel like the threads are thicker in an even weave than in a linen. And the linen, they vary in thickness, but I do like it. I feel like the even weave is very close, and the linen is a little bit more open, and it's easier to work with, for me anyway, if it's not that slubby. But yeah, how things can change, right? And last but not least, this morning I picked up Save the Stitches. And last time you saw it, I was almost ready with the last block 11 in a row. And I finished that this morning while watching FlossTube, because I'm trying to catch up. I'm way behind, although compared to some people, probably not that far behind. But yeah, so I needed to finish this motif. I did that, and I added in the metallics. And I've actually just stitched the border for block 12 as well. And yeah, I might actually finish that tomorrow by the looks of it, block 12, and that's a good thing because I'm kind of itching to start something, a little piece. And I figure, you know, I can combine the reward stitching with my Save the Stitches piece. And yeah, I'll show you. So I hope that, oh, maybe I should just show you once more the whole thing. Yeah, I hope that wasn't too quick for you guys, but yeah. So, there's a new start that I want to start, which is, I'm not sure if I showed you this. But yeah, this was on my mind ever since I saw the Coffee Quaker number 2 that was launched in Nashville. And I thought, hey, I still have this in my stash. Yeah, I need to stitch this, and it's pretty quick stitches. It's 75 wide by 100 high. It's four colors. I have the colors. I have some fabric, so I might start this. It's just a small piece. I might even have it finished next time. So yeah. That was my new start plan. Oh yeah. Then one final thing. I have been not showing you, but I have been gathering up some small pieces of fabric here and there because I don't like it when I get a fabric and it's not the color I was expecting. So I figured I need to go and look to some places where I can buy little pieces for not that much money and just see what it looks like. And for the small saying, the quotes that I have in my stash, those small pieces will be fine anyway, so I will find a use for them. But I just wanted to have a look at some neutrals and see what they look like. And I found a website here in the Netherlands that supplies Weeks Dye Works fabric as well as Swigart in some colors that I couldn't get in other places. And I got some from so and so, I think. But Sylvia, Becky's Land, yeah, I'm saying it right. Hi Sylvia. She was talking about Tin Roof Weeks Dye Works and that she couldn't get it because it was out of stock, and I thought I might as well show you what I've been gathering up and share with you what color they actually are. So what I did is I took out the swatches that I have and I matched them up with my DMC card with all the colors and tried to find the best matching DMC color, because you know, with computer screens and recording, you never know exactly how the color will come across. But if you can look in your own DMC stash for that color, you will have a good indication. So, long story short, that's what I did. So I have a few neutrals and a few dark neutrals and a blue one. And the blue one, it's all, some of it is 40 count, some of it is 32 count, it's all linen, just so you know. So this is a Swigart, smoky blue it's called. And this is, I like that a lot. It is coming across more blue than it is in real life. It is really like a bit gray green blue. But anyway, this is the matching DMC card 927, and I think this is a really interesting color. Oh, it matches my pajama pants actually, which I'm not going to show you. But yeah, it's just a 30 by 30 piece, I think. Oh, 35 by 35. But it's a Swigart linen, 40 count this one is. It's should be readily available. What I will try and do, if I remember, is add a list of all the things I'm showing you with the DMC colors and the color names from the fabric designer as well. But yeah, I like that blue. I think it might be nice for some of my sayings. But yeah, that was a good match. Then I have a Weeks Dye Works in Onyx. That was a surprise, because Onyx, as a geologist, to me Onyx, it's a volcanic glass. It has a really black, it's really black glass, really. But this is actually, don't know if you can tell, well, it looks black, but it is closest to 3371. It's actually a very, very, very dark brown. This is Weeks Dye Works linen, 32 count, as I said. This is where I got it, actually. So, Sylvia, this is where I got it. This is a 30 by 35 piece, which was not cheap, but the Zwijbaard ones are €4 each for a 30 by 30 piece, I think, 35, not sure, but check them out. The website is in Dutch, by the way. I don't think it's in English, but for the German-speaking public, it should be not too difficult. And if you get stuck, just let me know. I'll help you out. And then I got Tin Roof, Weeks Dye Works. I think I got that in the same place. And this is a tricky one. It is not what I was expecting. Tin roof makes me think like maybe a very light slate color, but it is looking like a raw linen. But it is actually closest to this DMC color. 3023. It is actually a grayish green, like an army khaki color. But very nice. This is a 32 count linen, tin roof. Then I have a, I think this is Zwijbaard, yeah. And I don't exactly know what color it is called in English. In Dutch it's anthracite, which is like a mineral. It's usually a very dark, almost black gray. That's why I got it, because I had the onyx too, so I figured I need to know. Now this is not an exact match, but this is the closest I have, 413. This again is a linen. I think it's a 40 count Zwijbaard. Then I have, this is the most tricky one, and I've never seen that color before. And I got it from that same, sorry for the crinkling. I got it from that same Dutch website, and this is the trickiest fabric to find a match to. I haven't found a good match to it at all. But this is a Zwijgaard Belfast 32 count linen. And it's all looking all terrible. It's not looking at all. This is like a taupe liver color, light liver color. But in some lights it looks a bit green, and some lights it looks more gray brown. And this is what I could come up with, which is, and as you can see, it's not at all a perfect match, but it's the closest I could find. It's a really strange, because as I said, in certain lights it does look very different. It's very interesting. Not sure what I'll stitch on it, but. Then we come to the neutrals, and there's two that are very similar in color, as you can see maybe. These are more of a pink, dusty pink color. The first one is Nougat. And this is also a Zwijgaard. And I don't have the DMC color, because it is very similar but not the same as this one. 452. It is actually a little bit more grayish than 452, but it's very close. It might just be that this is a 32 count Nougat and the other one I'm going to show you is a 40 count. That might explain the difference, because it is very close to this color. But this one, Zwijgaard as well, a 40 count, but called Rosewood. This is an exact match to this color. It is a Again, maybe a bit of a liver undertone in it, but taupe, dusty, rose kind of color. And this is 40 counts. And as a comparison, the 30 counts, as you can see, it is a bit more gray, the 32 counts. Yeah. And then I have two more natural linens. Also Swigart, also 40 counts Newcastle. 40 count Newcastle in the colorway Flex. I really like this. This is a really light, yeah, natural color sand. Not yellow at all. This is what it's closest to. I really like this one. I think this will be a good one for many different types of primitive patterns probably. And the last one is a shade darker than the Flex. And I don't have an exact DMC match, but this one is, this one is closest. This is raw, 40 counts, Edinburgh linen, Swigart, in the colorway raw linen. And the matching, or close to matching DMC color is this one. Yeah, also I really like these. I find it so interesting to see how my tastes have changed. Because 3 years ago I would never have stitched on raw linen. Ever. And now I think, oh, I really want to stitch on raw linen all the time. Anyway, those were the fabrics. And I can't believe I managed to do that in half an hour. I'm really excited about that. I'm sorry if it feels a bit rushed. And there's only one thing left to do, and that is... my random Dutch fact. And I was really thinking I was going to show you a bit more about the geography of the Netherlands. But next Wednesday we have our general election. And I figured I may not be in the mood to talk about politics after that, so might as well do it now. So I will just talk a little short bit about our political system, very, very briefly, because it's quite interesting when I look at places like Britain or France or United States, where there is only two or three big political parties, so the choice is rather limited. Well, that is not in our culture to have a little bit of choice, so we have a very interesting party political system in that for this general election for parliament I have the option of choosing between 28 parties. Yeah, take that in. Yeah, we have a system where if you have enough members, then you are eligible to be in parliament. So that means that people can vote for you in the next election. And we don't have a limit on how many parties there can be. So anyone who has enough members can have a political party. And there is you have to have enough votes to be entered into, to actually get a seat. So of those 28 parties that I can vote for, about 8, 9, something like that, are actually in parliament. And it also means that every time that we have an election, there is never one party that gets a majority vote. And that also means that after each election, there has to be a coalition forming. People have to make compromises on their political agenda and work together which I actually kind of like. But anyway, so we have 28 parties to choose from, and basically 6 to 10 big parties that actually end up in parliament, and they go from not the far right, but there's one party that is coming up that is rather right winged, and then there's a liberal party which is, I guess, close to the Democratic Party in the United States, but a lot more liberal than that. And then there are some central parties which have a Christian background mostly, and then there's the left-wing parties which vary from the Communist Party, which we still have, don't think they ever have a seat anymore, but two socialist green parties. But yeah, I'm still making up my mind what I'm going to do, who I'm going to vote for. It is kind of like in many other places in the last year or two where there's been elections, also here it is pretty heated and not exactly going in a direction that I would like to see our country move towards. But we'll see what the results will be. And that's what all I'm going to say about that. So yeah, if you ever think it's so hard to pick, just remember what I told you, it is even harder to pick with 28 choices. And there's also, oh yeah, I've got to say this, but there's also really fun, there's the, in the last year or two, I think there have been 5 new parties that have been added to that list. So there's parties like the Pirate Party. Don't ask me what their program is, I didn't even want to know. But yeah, there's a lot of one-issue parties that have been popping up in the last 10 years. But yeah, you know, if many people want to vote for them, then fine, you know. So that's it. I am amazed that I've managed to keep it under 45 minutes. I hope you don't think I've rushed you out of the door too hard. But yeah. When it's sunny out, I need to get some sun and need to wake up from my hibernation and actually do something. So that's what I'm gonna do, and I need also to get some financial administration in order because tax season is around the corner. Yeah, rabbit trails. Anyway, I hope you have a lovely 2 weeks. I expect to see you again in 2 weeks, and I hope you've gotten a lot of stitchy time in, or just nice outdoor time, or whatever. I hope you're doing well, all of you. I know I'm missing a few of my favorite FlossTubers lately, and I hope they're all well, and wishing you all a good 2 weeks, and yeah, see you again. Bye guys.